हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर एस आर दंडवते. आई वेलकम यू टू द सेकंड वीडियो ऑन इंटरफेरेंस, इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू हैव क्वालिटेटिव डिस्कशन अबाउट वेज फिल्म एंड ऑल्सो विल डिराइव द फ्रिंज विड्थ. एट द एंड ऑफ दिस लेक्चर लर्नर्स विल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ वेज फिल्म, दैट इज नॉन पैरेलल साइडेड फिल्म, एंड हेंस विल बी एबल टू डिराइव एंड डिस्कस द फ्रिंज विड्थ एंड इट्स consequences. Now in previous lecture we have seen parallel film like this. The thickness of the parallel film has uniform thickness. Currently we are discussing about wedge film, which is alternatively also called as non-parallel sided film. That means what will happen if the two reflecting surfaces are non-parallel, that we have to discuss. So in that case it will look like this. So for this non-parallel sided film, the thickness of the film is changing. See here, it has different thicknesses. Moreover, if this particular surface, if this line is extended, then somewhere here these two reflecting surfaces will contact, they will touch each other, and that structure will appear just like as wedge, and hence it is also called as wedge film. So let us consider this wedge shaped film and alpha be the wedge angle. So for this wedge film, our interest is to find out the conditions of constructive and destructive interference. So consider this as incident ray. This is incident ray. It makes angle I with respect to normal. Now from this point, it will be partly reflected and partly refracted. This refracted light passes through film and it has this as angle of refraction. Now at this point, it will be reflected in the film and then will pass through the air like this. Now from film it enters into the air, that's why it is bending slightly away from the normal. And here at this point we have assumed T as the thickness of the film. So these two are interfering rays and these are called as reflected light rays. Now this is very important. These two angles are found to be R plus alpha, and this is unique change between wedge film and parallel sided film. Already we have seen in parallel film these angles were R because these two surfaces were parallel to each other. There was no any inclination between the two surfaces. But in the present case, these two surfaces are having some angle in between, and this angle alpha is reflected over here. So remember this single change. So for this reflected system, our aim is to get the conditions of constructive and destructive interference, which will depend upon the value of path difference. Now from figure, the derived value of path difference comes out to be 2 mu t cos r plus alpha. In previous case, that means in parallel film, it was 2 mu t cos r only, but r is now replaced by r plus alpha. Now further we apply Stokes law, because we are talking about this reflected system, and this reflected system is produced at this interface where there is change in the medium from rarer to denser, and by Stokes law for such interface path changes by plus or minus lambda by 2. So that's why this derived path difference gets converted as effective path difference as 2 mu t cos r plus alpha plus or minus lambda by 2. However, for our sake of simplicity we have only considered plus sign, minus sign is hidden. And once we get this path difference, easily we can obtain the conditions of constructive and destructive just by recalling their basic conditions. That is, the condition is n lambda, path difference should be n lambda for constructive, it is equated with this effective path difference, and for destructive 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, and once again it is equated with this effective path difference, and rest is only the part of simplification. Shift this lambda by 2 on RHS and rearrange the terms. So equations becomes 2 mu t cos r plus alpha is equal to 2n minus 1 lambda by 2. This is expression for constructive interference, and 2 mu t cos r plus alpha is equal to n lambda, which is the formula for destructive interference for reflected system. Now we make generate transmitted system also. However, those rays are not shown in the diagram, but we can assume here transmitted system, and for transmitted system also we get derived path difference as 2 mu t cos r plus alpha, but only the change is there is change in the interface. If it is transmitted system here, means at the bottom of the film, then the interface is denser to rarer, and therefore according to Stokes law there will be no change in the path difference. That means whichever the path difference obtained as derived, it will remain same, and simply we have to equate it with either n lambda for constructive or with 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 for destructive interference. So that will give us the desired conditions for transmitter system. Let us now discuss some special cases of wedge film. So overall, three special cases we are going to discuss, which are if it is air film. That means between two reflecting surfaces, if medium is air, then mu is equal to 1. Second case is if there is normal incidence. That means if incident light falls along the normal, which will make I is equal to 0, and hence R also becomes 0. And third special case is thought as if value of alpha, that is wedge angle, is small, then cos alpha tends to 1. So these three special cases will be applied by recalling the formula of path difference for wedge film. So as we know that the path difference is 2 mu t cos R plus alpha plus lambda by 2. This already we have discussed. This is the path difference of wedge film in reflected light. Now, after applying these three special cases in this formula, this path difference will be simply 2 t plus lambda by 2. See here, mu is equal to 1, then R is equal to 0 due to normal incidence. So it is simply cos alpha. But cos alpha tends to 1 if we assume value of alpha small. That means this 2 mu t cos R plus alpha plus lambda by 2 becomes twice t plus lambda by 2 as a path difference. And from that, again, we can easily obtain the conditions of constructive as well as destructive interference. Now, if it is constructive interference, twice t plus lambda by 2 is equal to n lambda. Again, this lambda by 2 is shifted and it is rearranged so as to get t, that is thickness of the film, as 2n minus 1 lambda by 4. So if we write, if we put the values of n, then we get the different values of thicknesses as lambda by 4, 3 lambda by 4, 5 lambda by 4, and so on. In very similar manner, if we consider destructive interference, for destructive interference, see, this is our desired path difference, 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. But the path difference with us is 2t plus lambda by 2. So these two are equated, and once again we can simplify this for t, that is thickness of the film, by shifting this lambda by 2 on RHS and by simplifying further. So t becomes n lambda by 2. So let us put the values of n. So initially n is equal to 0, so t is equal to 0. Then n is equal to 1, it is lambda by 2, 2 lambda by 2, 3 lambda by 2 for different values of n. So these are the values of thicknesses. Now you observe these two equations. This is for bright and this is obtained for dark. Now if these two equations are carefully studied, we get some common conclusion from that. It is observed that for these successive bright bands, there is equal change in the thickness. The meaning is bright bands are equally spaced. Same observation comes here. At t is equal to 0, that means at the point where two reflecting surfaces touch each other, t is equal to 0. And this condition comes under destructive interference. That means that point will appear dark. And that dark point will be followed by number of dark bands at the values of thicknesses lambda by 2, 2 lambda by 2, and so on. That means these dark bands are also equally spaced. And now finally, if we combine these two equations, then we get some important conclusion. Any two successive dark or bright bands are equally spaced, as well as when we see this wedge film in the reflected light. See, these conditions are already obtained for reflected light only. So for reflected light, the point of contact, this point of contact appears dark, and it is then followed by alternate bright and dark straight bands which are equally located, which are equidistant. So this is an important conclusion obtained for wedge film. So with that idea, let us now try to find out the fringe width, that is band width, and it is denoted by beta. So for that purpose, once again we have to consider wedge film with wedge angle alpha. Now, as discussed just now, we know that this point of contact for reflected light we are talking. So this point of contact will be dark, followed by first bright band, then first dark band, second bright, second dark. Like this, if we continue, somewhere here we'll have nth bright band. that is nth bright fringe, and suppose the thickness of the film is T at that position. The next bright band will be n plus 1. So we know that between this nth bright and n plus 1th bright band, there is one dark band. That means if we consider from this point to this point, somehow if this distance is obtained, that will give us the fringe width of this dark band. Okay, so that we have to obtain. So let us further imagine that this nth bright band, nth bright fringe is located at distance xn from point of contact, and the distance from point of contact up to n plus 1th bright band is xn plus 1. This is our assumption. So by simplifying, by considering this diagram, we can easily find out xn plus 1 minus xn. If this difference is taken, definitely that difference will be in the form of beta, that is the fringe width. So this is our aim, to find out this difference between these two distances. So for that purpose, we can once again recall our expression for path difference for wedge film in reflected light, which is 2 mu t cos r plus alpha plus lambda by 2. Let us first of all assume that there is normal incidence. So for normal incidence, r becomes 0 and the path difference takes the form 2 mu t cos alpha plus lambda by 2. Now let us find out the value of t. Let us replace this t in terms of xn, because we want to find out the difference between xn plus 1 and xn. So how can we introduce xn in this equation? By replacing this t, and that substitution can be obtained from the diagram. So we'll consider tan alpha. See, look at the figure. If we take tan alpha, it is this t upon xn, opposite side upon adjacent side, and hence we have t is equal to xn tan alpha, which we can put in the previous expression of delta. So this equation of delta becomes 2 mu xn. See, here t is substituted. So xn tan alpha cos alpha as it is plus lambda by 2. So tan alpha cos alpha becomes sin alpha. Okay. Now from this equation, we can obtain the expression for bright. See, already what we have assumed, it is nth bright. That means for nth bright fringe, what we can write? Path difference is equal to n lambda. That's why this equation of delta is equated with n lambda, and it is simplified here. This lambda by 2 is shifted on RHS and it is rearranged. So this way the equation is now available in terms of xn. One requirement is fulfilled. Now what is another requirement? What is our beta? Beta is xn plus 1 minus xn. So in which already we have obtained this xn, remaining is xn plus 1. So in very similar manner, we can obtain expression of xn plus 1 also, simply by replacing n in this equation. N can be replaced by n plus 1. That equation looks like this. See here, 2 mu xn plus 1 sin alpha is equal to 2. See, this n is replaced by n plus 1 minus 1 as it is into lambda by 2. So solve this bracket, it becomes 2n plus 1 lambda by 2. So in this next step, difference is taken. This equation, this entire equation minus this previous equation, so that we can easily get the difference xn plus 1 minus xn. This 2 mu and sin alpha are common. This is LHS, and on RHS, this is 2n plus 1 lambda by 2 minus 2n minus 1, this one, 2n minus 1 lambda by 2, and this can be simplified as beta. This difference is equivalent to beta, the fringe width, which is equal to lambda upon 2 mu sin alpha. I will show you previous. See, RHS is simplified, 2n into lambda by 2, 2 cancels, it is n lambda, then plus 1 into lambda by 2 means lambda by 2, then minus 2n into lambda by 2, 2 cancels and it is n lambda means minus n lambda, then last term is minus minus plus 1 into lambda by 2. So by simplifying this entire RHS, the remaining is only lambda. and this 2 mu and sin alpha are shifted on RHS. So that equation becomes lambda upon 2 mu sin alpha. Okay, and now we can assume that alpha is very small, then sin alpha will tend to alpha, and this equation gets modified into lambda upon 2 mu alpha. Now here, if required, you can replace this mu by 1 if it is air film, or otherwise for any material, any medium having refractive index mu, it will be beta is equal to lambda upon 2 mu alpha, which is desired expression of fringe width. Now this is very important equation. From this equation we may have several conclusions or different cases can be thought. I will give you one example. Suppose we are performing the experiment with fringe width. Beta is measured and it is obtained for lambda, which is sodium source, that is yellow color, and certain beta is obtained. Now if the same experiment is repeated just by replacing the source instead of yellow colored source, now if I use red colored monochromatic source, then whether it will affect beta? Yes, definitely, because as we shift from yellow color to red color, lambda is changing. This denominator is constant. We are not changing mu, we are not changing alpha, film is as it is. Only we are changing the source which is used for illumination purpose, and that change is from yellow to red. That means lambda is in increasing order. So as it is in numerator, what will happen to beta? Beta will increase. So like this, you can imagine several cases. What will happen if we change the medium? What will happen if we change alpha somehow? How, in what way it will affect beta, that is fringe width. So this was about the fringe width. In next lecture, we will discuss application of wedge film for Newton's rings. Thank you.